Hello, good morning students. We will continue our history chapter 2, that is New Kings and Kingdoms. Till now we have learned about the North India. Now we are going to learn about what are the changes that happened in South India. That topic starts from Puraiya to Thanjavur. Now, where is the place Puraiya and where is Thanjavur and what is its importance? That I am going to tell you. There was a subordinate of the Pallavas who were called Muthariya. These Muthariyas were ruling on behalf of Pallav kings in the region of Kanchipuram. He was the ruler of Pallavas, were the ruler of Kanchipuram. Presently Kanchipuram is in Tamil Nadu. So he was ruling over the delta of Kaveri Delta, that is delta of Kaveri. Kaveri is a very famous river, and delta means you understand the land with the near the river, a triangular shape near the river is called delta. So that delta is ruled by Muthariya, who were the subordinate of the Pallav kings of Kanchipuram. However, in the 9th century, Muthariyas were defeated by Vijayadaya. Vijayadaya belongs to a chiefly family of the Chola Empire. Chola is again in the South India. He has defeated Muthariya. The Chola were ruling, captured that in the middle of the 9th century. They were and established his own rule in the Kaveri Delta. So he becomes, the Vijayadaya becomes the new king. He built the new town that is called Thanjavur. Actually, they belongs to the Puraiya. So from Puraiya, he has shifted his capital to Thanjavur. So that's why it is said that a chieftain captured the delta in the need of the situation and established his own rule, and he has shifted his capital from Puraiya to the Thanjavur. He also made Thanjavur his new city that is made by him. And he also made a temple for goddess Nishumbha Shudini. It is very important temple. Presently also it is available in Tamil Nadu near Kanchipuram. Thanjavur is the new capital of Pallavas, of Vijayadaya from the Cholas. So Chola ruler started to rule from Thanjavur. Now, after establishing the Chola Empire at Thanjavur, the successor of Vijayadaya started to attack over the suburb nearby regions and nearby kingdoms and expanded his area. That means the successor of Vijayadaya conquered neighboring regions and the kingdoms grow in size and power. मतलब विजयराया के जो बाद के राजा हुए उसके वंश के, उन्होंने अपने आसपास के जो क्षेत्रों के राजा थे उन पर चढ़ाई किया और उनको जीत कर अपने पावर को और ज्यादा से ज्यादा बढ़ाया। इन्होंने इन चोला वंश में जो सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट राजा है उसका नाम आता है राज राजा वो। He is considered to be the most powerful ruler of the kingdoms. He also recognized, so he also reorganized the administration of the empire. That means उसने फिर से उस empire को establish किया and he had established his kingdom in 985. ठीक है? He established in 985. After him, his son Rajendra I continued to his policy and even he raided up to the valley Ganga. So, Ganga Valley is also in the north by him and even he built the navy and with the help of navy he has plundered or attacked over even Sri Lanka and neighboring islands. So, most powerful two ruler of the Chola Empire is Rajendra I and his son, sorry, Raj Raja I and his son Rajendra I. Now, our next topic is splendid temples and bronze sculptures. Why splendid temples? मतलब बड़े temple were not only the places of worship. Temples were not only the places of worship, but also they are hub of economic, social and cultural life as well. That means the temples were creating a lot of jobs. They also used to provide economic help to the farmers by giving the loans as they used to work as a banker. Social activities, whenever there is any social activities that is related to religious function, like suppose there is Janmashtami, Krishna Janma, so a fair is organized, a mela wahan par lagta tha. वहाँ पर डांस होते थे, सांस्कृतिक कार्यक्रम होते थे, so cultural activities were also done at that place, and that's why the new kings used to make the big temples and they used to donate the land. That lands were used, the produce of that land were used to maintain the temples, and also a lot of garland maker, a lot of sculpture is made them. जैसे आज भी हम अगर मंदिरों के पास जाते हैं तो भगवान की मूर्तियों को लेकर आते हैं. So they और वहाँ पर पूजा करने के लिए माली लोग होते हैं जिनसे हम फूल माला खरीदते हैं. तो ये सब भी वहाँ पर होता था, लोगों को रोजगार मिलता था. You can find in your book on page number 24 there is a bronze temple. So among the craft associated with temple, the making of bronze image was the most distinctive. Chola bronze images are considered among the finest in the world, while most images were of deities, that is Devi Devata, okay. Sometimes images were made of devotee as well. Jo log bahut jyada prashansak hote the Devi Devata ke, unke bhi murtiyan banayi jati thi, lekin zyadatar murtiyan जो बनाई जाती थी या तांबे के बने हुए स्कल्पचर से जो मूर्तियां बनती थी वो सब ज्यादातर देवी देवताओं के. ओके.